Hello friends, welcome to this YouTube video program. Friends, we are discussing about different recommendations relating to school education, which is given in National Education Policy 2020. We have already discussed few aspect of recommendations in school education relating to pedagogy, relating to the pedagogical structure of school education. That's called as the 5+3+3+4 system of education, pedagogical structure of education. And in our earlier program, we have discussed about certain pedagogical aspect. And in this program, just further we will discuss that what are the other aspect that has been discussed, that has been recommended relating to school education, especially pedagogical aspects of school education for designing 4 stages of education. That is the foundational stage, preparatory stage, middle stage, as well as the secondary stage of education. Okay, it starts from age of 3 and it continues till the age of 18. Okay, so at the age of 3, the child, they will start the Anganwadi education, then after preschool, then after Balvatika. So 3 years they will spend in the foundational stage with 2 years of formal schooling, that's called as class 1 and 2. So taking this 5 years, this has been conceptualized as a foundational stage, that is 5 years of schooling. Then 3 years of preparatory schooling, that is class 3, 4 and 5th. Then further 3 years of middle stage, that is class 6, 7 and 8. That's called as the upper primary stage earlier, but now it is the middle stage. Then further 4 years of secondary education, starting from class 9th to 12th, class 9th, 10th, then after class 11th and 12th. But there is an exit option after completion of 2 years of secondary education, that means after completion of the 10th class. Okay, so one can take an exit and can join in any specialized school, maybe in any technical and vocational courses. Okay, so that one can also do. Otherwise, one can also continue this 4 years of schooling, that is the secondary education. So friends, this is the structure, this is the basic pedagogical structure. Very soon it is going to be implemented across the country. Okay, so now different awareness program is going on across the country in the educational institutions, in schools, colleges, okay, in any research organization, research institutions. Okay, government is also wholeheartedly participating for spreading or developing awareness about this NEP 2020. But here the basic we have already discussed, but still then certain specific things that has been addressed in school education we will discuss in this video. First of all, the holistic education, you will find that emphasis is given in this NEP 2020 about the achievement of holistic education. Means the education that we are imparting, that should not be a partial education, that should not be a part education. If you will go through the concept of education given by Mahatma Gandhi and other educationists, you will find that somewhere a holistic concept of education that has been reflected, total development of human personality. If you will go through the definition of education given by Mahatma Gandhi, you will find that this has been emphasized, that education is for all-round development of human personality. Okay, so it includes physical development, mental development, social development, emotional development. Okay, so all types of development when happens within the individual, then we can say yes, the holistic development of education is going on. Then further for implementing holistic education system, you will find that our curriculum should be holistic in approach. Okay, so all types of development which is required within an individual, that should be the part of our curriculum. So accordingly, you will find that specifically certain specific content areas, how to design the content, what are the skills should be developed by the students from a curriculum, from a particular stage of education, that also being discussed in this NEP 2020. So that's why one of the fundamental principles or the pedagogical principles that has been addressed in the NEP 2020 is the holistic education, achievement of holistic education, further integrated education. So friends, you see, when we talk about integrated education, it means how to integrate all types of knowledge, how to integrate theory with practice. Okay, so how to integrate theoretical knowledge with different hands-on activities, hands-on practices. After all, now across the globe, you will find that care has been taken and importance has been given, and groundwork has already started that how to develop a competency-based, a skill-based programs. Means we can say that what is the graduating skill? Means what competencies one should achieve at a particular stage of education, at the foundational stage of education, at the preparatory stage of education. Earlier we are saying it is the minimum level of learning. Okay, so what minimum level of learning one should achieve, one should attend from after completion of a particular stage of education. So now we are saying that competencies, what competency, what language competency, numeric competency, competencies of coping oneself with the world of work, with the development or the with the happenings over the globe. Okay, so that is also a part of that's called as the graduation skills. Okay, the competency of a program. So that's why unless we integrate our curriculum, we integrate different knowledge, different aspects of knowledge in curriculum, then it is not possible to establish a better culture, a better culture of teaching and learning, a better integrated culture, integrated academic culture in the school system. It's not possible. So that's why the pedagogical aspect, which is given importance upon the integrated education, then further inclusive education, that is also another pedagogical concept, pedagogical importance that has been given, recommendations that has been given in NEP 2020. So friends, we talk about the children's who are coming to the school system are from different diverse background, from different diversified areas. So that's why how to provide a similar types of culture, how to provide a similar types of educational input at the school. Okay, so how to design our curriculum, because all are not from the same ability, all are not from the same language background, all are not from the same socio-economic status. Okay, all are not from the same educational background family. Okay, so far as parent education is concerned, so far as family culture tradition is concerned, you will find that there is a very wide differences. Okay, so far as culture, tradition, language, the living style of the people are concerned. So that's why how to establish a better inclusive system of education. So friends, you will find that we consider all our school is inclusive school as per NCF 2005. Already this has been practiced, this has been practiced in the school education system, and the recommendation of integrated and inclusive education further it strengthens the earlier practices of education. Then further you will find that specially at the foundational stage, at the same time, even if in the preparatory stage of education as per the NEP 2020, care has been given or importance has been given on the enjoyable learning and activity-based learning. Okay, so how the young child will engage themselves in different types of play activities, in different types of dramatization, in different types of storytelling. Okay, so how they will learn with engaging themselves in different types of activities. That activities may be related to mathematics, that activities may be related to other subjects. So you will find that for developing a sense of enjoyment in the school, if the child will not enjoy the school system, will not enjoy the curriculum, will not enjoy the content that has been incorporated in the curriculum, then you can say that there is no learning. So that's why, friend, care has been taken that how the interesting content, enjoyable content, interesting activities, enjoyable activities will included, specially at the first foundational and preparatory stage of education, so that wholeheartedly, with full of interest, the students, the young children will engage in the teaching learning process. So these are the pedagogical approach that, basing upon this pedagogical principle, the entire curriculum will be designed by NCERT. Then further, the other principles, other pedagogical principles that has been discussed, that is engaging in learning. So here the effort of the teacher or the effort of our education system should engage the learners. You will find that the present practices or what is happening across India now, the children, the students, they are developing a rote memory, okay, a rote learning. Before the examination, they are just cramming certain things, they develop rote memory and they reproduce it in the examination. So how to curb such situation, how to stop such situation? So for, if we engage the learners in the teaching learning process throughout the year continuously, then we can develop, a sense of understanding of the content in the school. We can engage the students, actively engage the students in the process of teaching and learning. So that's why how to engage in learning is also one of the pedagogical, you can say, principle that has been recommended in NEP 2020. Then further, this has been particularly discussed, that how to develop the experiential learning, okay, means learning based upon one's experience. You will find that as per the constructivist approach of teaching and learning, the children who are coming to the school campus, coming to the school system, they are having ample experiences. They have experiences, about this world. They have experiences about their immediate environment, about their society, about their community, about their family, friend circle, peers, groups, playmates, club members. So here, how to use their experience in the teaching learning process in the curriculum? That is also another basing upon which the curriculum will be designed at the school stage. Then further, flexible education. As I have already discussed in my earlier video, that scope will given, especially at the secondary stage of education, enough scope will be given to the students, to the young students, that they can select a subject of their own choice. If they want to study art and culture, they can select. If they want to study craft as a subject, they can also study. If they want to study sports education, they can also study. So here, options, you will find that the varieties of options will be given to the students for selecting subject of their interest, of their aptitude. So that's why the flexible education, implementation of flexible education, is also one of the important aspect so far as school education is concerned. Then further, inquiry-based learning, discovery-based learning is also another aspect. Means how to engage the learners for inquiring themselves, for inquiring the world, for inquiring the world where they're living, inquiring the environment where they're living, or inquiring the happenings of the society. So friends, you see, the young child, their mind is just to know more and more, and just to ask questions, why such things are happening, and why such things are not happening also, okay? So their inquisitive mind, so how to satisfy their inquisitive mind? So unless our curriculum is engage the learners for satisfying their inquiry, for satisfying their discovery mind, then you can't say that the curriculum is a better curriculum. So that's why there should be enough scope, enough space in the curriculum for developing these discovery-based ideas, discovery-based knowledge, and inquiry-based ideas, inquiry-based knowledge. Okay, so that's why certain innovative content, certain science-related experiment, demonstration-related content, which requires certain hands-on activities, which requires certain involvement of the students for doing certain things. It may be within the classroom, it may be outside the classroom even, it may be in a natural setting, okay? So they will engage themselves in different types of inquiry, in different types of questions that that comes to the mind of the students, of the children. So that is also another pedagogical part of designing the school education structure. Then further, I have already discussed that a wider choices of subject, that has been given, wider choices of subject. So especially at the secondary stage, you will find that the students will engage themselves in selecting subjects of their choice. Then further, integrating assessment strategies, integration of constructivist assessment strategies in the teaching learning process. Okay, so how to emphasize the formative assessment, not the summative assessment, means how engage the learners in teaching learning process, at the same time self-assessment during the pedagogical process, during the teaching learning process, means when there is a matter of teaching, then definitely certain continuous assessment will be incorporated in the process of teaching. Okay, it may be through observation, it may be through interview, it may be through class discussion, it may be through a class debate, a seminar, a group discussion. Okay, so by doing this, we can engage the students and we can also assess the progress of the students, the involvement of the students. Okay, so that's why you can say if you do such type of assessment, further that assessment will help for enhancing their learning, and they can acquaint themselves, they can understand that in which aspect they are strong and in which aspect they are weak, and how they will modify themselves, how they will improve themselves. Then further, another pedagogical concept that has been discussed, that how to reduce the curriculum. So now this has been realized that our school curriculum is it is overloaded. So unless we reduce the curriculum, then we cannot give proper space for critical thinking, proper space for inquiry based learning, proper space for discovery based, for discussion based, analysis based learning. So friends, for giving a space to for the development of such type of critical thinking, discovery learning, inquiry based learning, and critically analyzing the things. Okay, so we cannot develop holistic knowledge among the students. So that's why this has been recommended in NEP 2020, that the curriculum should be some extent reduced, and with that place, the other activities, other hands-on activities, creative activities, activities related to attitude of the students, competency-based activities, skill-based activities will be incorporated, so that a practical, a practice-oriented knowledge the students will get from their schooling. Okay, so friends, these are the certain very pertinent, very important things that has been recommended in NEP 2020, especially for designing pedagogy, designing teaching learning process at different stages of school education. In our next program, we will discuss the other aspect, the other recommendations relating to higher education, and other aspect of education of the children. Thank you.